Welcome to today's conversation, Think Differently. You know, they say you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Well, let me just say this. When it comes to learning new tactics and new approaches on ways to communicate your story about credit unions or to attract the attention of the news media or to engage your audience, it's always important that we as communicators, whether we're old or we're young, you know, stay up to date on the latest trends that impact how we can ensure our success in telling our stories. You know, and if not, then I say it's time that we think about putting away our pens or our laptops and call it the end of a career, right? I'm Walt Laskos, and joining me is Isaiah Moskowitz.
You are spot on with Think Differently, Walter. I mean, in this day and age, if you don't think differently, you know, times are going to pass you by. I think of all the years I spent in the broadcast world and all the things I've done with advertising and with clients. And every day you have to think differently. You have to tell your story, and you have to tell that story differently every single time. We'll get into some of the stories I've seen over the past 30 years, but you have a really interesting story when you were out west with Operation Blessing, right?
Best wishes.
Thank
you. It was a blessing to many. It really was.
This is a great story. You know, tell the folks about this story.
But you know, and I think I want to use my tale of Operation Best Wishes as a way, as kind of like a white paper, as an example of how thinking differently helped me achieve a lot of media exposure. Yep. And publicity and good PR for credit unions that were engaged in that program. Operation Best Wishes takes me back to my days when I was working at Western Corporate Federal Credit Union. And at that time, this is around 2004, WestCorp got involved with Tom Glatt and CIA Associates about using their webcasting technology, which is new at that time, right? Think of it, 2004, to use that as a way to do outreach to the members of WestCorp, thinking that we could do educational programs to help folks understand the different financial products and services that WestCorp offered, and then as a result, you know, they'll be more likely to engage with our products.
Right.
So, all right, this is brand new. We now have a webcast studio. Okay, Walter, you're the PR guy. Get us publicity. You got to do a news release. So that's a typical thing, right?
Right.
Do a news release.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking to myself, well, you know, we have all this technology around us. Do we do a news release, or do I look for something different? Do I come up with an idea here that can really get us some exposure? Now,
tell a different story.
Exactly. And you know what was going on at that time, 2004? It was the Iraqi war.
Right.
So we have a war going on. We have all these military going overseas to Afghanistan and Iraq, the whole bit. And we're in Southern California, and there's a lot of military bases around the whole bit. So I'm going, you know, why don't we do this? Suppose we open the doors of our webcast studio to military families. Because this was, say, toward the end of the year, and the holidays are coming up. So let's have them webcast holiday greetings, right, to their deployed loved ones.
That's great.
Right?
That's great.
So if they did that, they come in, they see the studio, and it's like the message about WestCorp having this technology and using it for its members is kind of like on the back burner,
right,
but yet it's still visible, it's still being communicated to the audience.
You're talking about the studio and the cast, but it's with the military stories.
Exactly.
Which is the story, you were thinking differently.
Exactly, and the thing is, too, I'm also riding the coattails because we're talking about having the military participate,
right,
in this.
Right.
So there was a credit union that was on Camp Pendleton, Pacific Marine Credit Union.
Okay.
We say, all right, let's bring our cameras, and we'll set up there, and we'll do the recordings, and then we could webcast those to the troops overseas. I send out a media alert, mm-hmm, to the news media saying that, you know, we're going to be at this credit union. Here's what's going to be happening the whole bit. So, of course,
they pay attention.
You know, oh, they did, because this technology, webcasting, and remember, this is before Zoom and
right,
everything like that. So they were all in. We hit a home run.
Well, and you're talking to the military. You're talking to these men and women who are freshly overseas with this war. You're communicating with them, and yet you're also exposing this new technology.
Exactly.
Brilliant.
Exactly. So basically,
did you get a raise?
We set up shop. Yeah, that would have been nice, wouldn't it? But we did score big ones when it right. came to attracting news media and making a great name for Pacific Marine in terms of the PR branding of what it was doing for its members, the whole bit. As a matter of fact, part of the reason for using this as a white paper is I still have a lot of the artifacts, a lot of the videos of what we did. Basically, we set up a couple chairs, we have a couple cameras, some of our webcasting gear, and we have the folks sign up, reservist time. They come, they sit down, and we give them like 5-10 minutes to share their stories, but basically to send their greetings to their deployed loved ones.
Wow.
And as you can imagine, there were a lot of tears, so we had to have the Kleenex boxes on hand.
Was it brought to you by tissue?
Sort of thing too. Yeah, exactly.
Product placement.
And it really did well. But anyway, let me share this video with you that will give you an insider look at Operation Best Wishes. It's tied in with a lot of the photos, tied in with some of the news media successes that were part of that whole initiative.
For families and loved ones who are serving in the military, and it's a time when they can be actually painfully lonely.
However, there is a group of volunteers on a mission to bring holiday cheer to the troops and their families this Christmas. ABC4's Angie Larson just returned from a special assignment called Operation Best Wishes. Angie?
That's right, Randall. Operation Best Wishes was started 4 years ago by West Corps Federal Credit Union and the Defense Credit Union Council. The organization travels to credit unions that serve the military all over the country. Today, they set up shop at America First Credit Union in Riverdale to connect families to their soldiers overseas.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey, David, how you doing? Guess who? You never thought I'd be doing this, did you?
With tears of sorrow and joy, Macheko Nakashima Lizarazo sends a personal greeting to her brother serving in the Navy.
I just don't want to say bye, but I think my time's up. We love you and we miss you.
She says email is good, but is grateful for this personalized opportunity.
It brings us closer to our families, and I know it's going to make a difference.
Megan Crossan is 9 months pregnant with her first babies, twin girls.
We're going to have our two little girls here shortly for the next couple of days, hopefully. I love you. Merry Christmas.
Her husband, Brody, is a Marine and has been deployed since September. Megan says it's very difficult to go through this alone.
Just everything that you have to go through, that he's not here to get to see and that he's missing out on. It's been hard for him because this is kind of a once-in-a-lifetime thing, having twins, and he's missing out on everything.
Credit unions usually use this mobile webcast studio for training, but during the holidays, the technology is made available to Operation Best Wishes.
Words probably cannot express it, because when families are separated for the holidays, there's a lot of pain, and to have an opportunity where we could give them that chance of connecting with the deployed loved ones.
You're a godsend. Thank you so very much.
Yeah. Say daddy. Say daddy. Say I love you, daddy. Say daddy. No. But take care, baby, and can't wait till you come back home. I love you. Oh. That's it. Bye. Say bye-bye. He's like, I don't know.
Just want to say hi. Hope all is well over there. Chico and I were doing fine. We miss you. We love you. Don't he look cute in his little sweater and his bling bling?
Christmas isn't going to be the same without you, but I know that everything's going to be okay, and I'll be seeing you in, like, 5 more months, right? It's just, Like, it's hard just coming home, you know, and not having you there. But I just wanted to wish you a happy or Merry Christmas. Let you know that everything's fine and that I'm going to be here for you no matter what, every step of the way. And I love you very, very much.
So there you go. You can see that Operation Best Wishes really was very effective in how it touched people, in how it touched the military, and in what it really meant for Western Corporate Federal Credit Union, the company where I work.
That's a really powerful story because you did, like you said, it started with put a press release out about this new technology, and you said, well, no one's going to care about that. You know, I know a lot of people put press releases out, and you may think it's important, but you have to get the news media's attention. So by you switching it around to say, let's use this technology and let's send messages to the troops from their family, home run.
Well, you know, one of the things too is that we do the program from like maybe just before Thanksgiving all the way through to just around the Christmas holiday.
Okay.
So around the Thanksgiving time, we found a little turkey outfit that could fit like a five-year-old.
That's great.
Right?
Okay.
So that turkey outfit wound up on more front pages on newspapers throughout the country than anything else.
You're giving them content.
Because, yes, the family would come in, the mom would come in with the little kids, and if we spotted someone that looked like they were about 4 or 5 years old, we said, how about we put the turkey outfit on them? We put them on, we put them in the front. Well, the newspapers are clipping up to it. And I remember we were at a Marine Credit Union in Jacksonville, South Carolina. Was it South Carolina? North Carolina.
Okay.
Because that's Camp Lejeune, the Marines, mm-hmm. right? And the following day, you know, after doing Operation Best Wishes, we're leaving the hotel. And I looked out at the newspaper machine. I'm going like, whoa!
There was the kid.
There's the front page of the paper, and there's the picture, and there's the little kid with the turkey outfit.
Perfect.
On the front page. On the front page. Mm-hmm.
You can't buy that kind of that media either.
You
cannot buy that kind of media. You have to think differently and think about how the media is looking at things, how the editors are thinking, the producers, not, hey, here's my idea and force it on someone, but now you're talking to military mm-hmm. people, and guess who else gets credit? The credit unions got all the credit.
And you know, it's almost too, like, you have to actually think like they think,
correct.
Too, that that's 100%. Part of the process.
Exactly.
Because, you know, like, for example, that little outfit on that little five-year-old, that's very, very cute. They're going to eat that up. That's why this little kid was on the front.
I can hear the cameras clicking. I can hear the interviews and the film rolling.
The same thing happened once with the Seattle Times.
Okay.
You know, we had an opportunity there where I worked with a specific reporter, and we were at the local military base. The reporter did the story, and it was Christmas Eve.
Okay.
Sunday newspaper mm-hmm. in Seattle. And we were on, it was like the local section or so, front page.
Wow.
I mean, you can't buy that.
People get so frustrated these days, too, when they say, well, why doesn't the media follow my story? You know, there's a ton of credit unions out there. You all do amazing work. Your cause marketing is amazing, and they are great causes. But if it doesn't click in the ecosystem of that reporter that day, it's just not going to make the mm-hmm. news. You hit a nerve those two times with the stories and then with the kid in the, you know, turkey outfit.
Exactly.
If I'm sitting there, I need something on the front page for Thanksgiving. Obviously, it's going to be a turkey. Now you've got a child, and they're talking to them. It's a
yeah,
whole run.
Yeah, the military, the work, the tears from the, you know, it all plays out. And what the nice thing about this was, too, is, you know, when you start thinking differently, mm-hmm. particularly if you're at a credit union, a lot of times we think about our credit union and our institution, but what about our members?
Right.
And in this case, at West Corp was a corporate credit union. We had credit unions themselves that were members of our credit union,
okay.
right?
Yep.
So this was making our member credit unions look good.
Right.
So we would go to the different credit unions that were serving the military. We would set up our Operation Best Wishes mobile studio.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the families would come in, they would be on television, that they got a lot of press coverage.
Wow.
The focus wasn't on West Corp, but it was talking about the local credit union. That's the one that got in the news. And look at the great stuff the credit union is doing for these military families to reach out to their deployed loved
right.
ones.
Right.
It scored such fantastic press coverage for that local credit union at a time when stories of that caliber, mm-hmm. you know, when you think about it, with the war, with the families left behind. And I have to say, though, when you look at some of the stories that families would come and record these stories, you know, some of them were, I remember a story once where this was at a Marine credit union, right? The lady comes in pushing a little carriage. I thought it was a little baby in it. Mm. There were two little chihuahuas in there in a little fancy frilly outfit.
Right, right.
And they were the pride of this big, tough Marine's life who's stationed overseas. I'm going like, who would ever think a Marine, right, is going to be like two little dogs in their little lacy outfits.
Right,
but they were his pride and joy, and she brought him in.
And right? Videoed that and sent it over.
And there were other times, too, where we had to almost turn off the cameras because it was getting a little bit X-rated, you know, when you have a wife coming in and her husband is overseas.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, that was, but it was a, the way I looked at it, it not only achieved a lot for the credit unions, for what we were able to do through Operation Best mm-hmm. Wishes, but it really did, you know, it was an honor, I felt, for myself and for those that worked with me at West Corp to be able to provide this service.
Well, you connected these people. You
exactly.
helped them stay connected at a time.
Mm-hmm.
This is 2004, remember. This is as the war is starting. This is right when this whole thing blew up, for lack of a better term, and you are giving these families and these military folks a way to stay in touch. I mean, certainly now these days, Zoom, you're up and you're going, but in 2004, and that's
going
to get us to some of our conversations now. It's 2021. You can't just sit and do the same things over and over again.
Well, that leads me to talk about you and your career. So you're telling me about maybe some 30-some years now you're approaching now, being in the news media business up in New England. Actually, not even just New England, but I understand Florida, all over the country.
Yep.
So you're doing all this sort of thing. You talk about the kind of news media channels that we have today. We're talking here about thinking differently.
Right.
And when I say stuff like thinking differently, you must have seen prime examples of that throughout your career in the business, of those who thought differently and look at what they were able to score,
right,
and those that did the same old, same old, same old, and where did that result?
They fell behind.
So share some of your stories.
Yeah, absolutely. I appreciate it. I mean, I've been in the broadcast world and the marketing and advertising world for almost 30 years now. You know, I started as an on-air personality on a radio station in Bangor, Maine. Stephen King owns the radio station, a little rock and roll radio station. And, you know, now 30 years later, I own my own advertising agency, and it's a boutique agency. I do it, and I work directly with clients. But the road from 1990 to now, it's littered with all sorts of things where you definitely have to think differently. Think about any radio show that I ever hosted. Every time you open your mouth on a microphone, you need to think differently about the people that are listening. You have to know who you're talking to every single time, or you're no longer listening to my radio show.
That's right. And it's all about ratings.
That's
and if you don't, if you're not attracting the audience,
exactly.
Bye-bye.
Howard Stern was the best at it. He knew exactly every quarter hour how to make people listen beyond that quarter hour into the next quarter hour. If you read any of his books, he was just a genius at it. You know, frankly, he said he, you know, insulted and irritated a lot of people, but he knew what he was doing. The ratings were gangbusters, and, you know, that's a perfect example. And I looked up to people like Howard Stern and Charles Lockwoodera on WBCN in Boston and various personalities to become that on-air personality. And then, moving from that, I got an opportunity to start working in the creative department, writing and producing the commercials for the clients, for the people, advertisers much like potentially yourself, that used radio and you used it as your medium to advertise. So I got into writing and thinking differently for your credit union, your car dealership, your, you know, furniture store, whatever it may be. How do we write and produce and sound different every day to get them to come to your Jordans, to get them to come to your Waltz Automotive or so-and-so's credit union? You can't just take copy and say, we're open at 9, closed at 5, and we're here on Main Street. Wow, that's boring. You have to think about the story inside the credit union. Tell me what you do for your charitable arm. You know, we work with so many credit unions that work with some fantastic cause marketing you know, groups. Tell those stories. Tell the stories of the veterans that you work with. Mm-hmm. Tell the stories of the kids you help. I know, give an example of our folks in New Hampshire. You know, Make-A-Wish is littered with amazing stories of what they do for terminally ill kids. You know, in Massachusetts, the Coalition for the Homeless, working with Robin and that whole team to help the unhoused. You know, talk about the folks in Delaware with the Boys and Girls Club, or down in Rhode Island with Special Olympics. there are thousands of stories right there, much like your story, where it's not about the credit union, it's about the credit union working with these foundations and doing amazing things.
Well, you know, and that kind of sets up in my mind when I think of how many times credit unions will put out a news release that, oh, we gave a $1,500 check to, let's say, Special Olympics.
Sure.
And that, all the hoopla is just focused around that. I say, do think differently, focus on the end result of where that $1,500 is going and how it's touching someone there. And then you point the direction at that and make that the story. And in the background, you're the one that made that happen because of a $1,500 check that you gave to Special Olympics on that. So you're still promoting your gift, but you're, I think, doing a better job at attracting the media attention because they're going to more apt to go after, look how that impacted this Special Olympian, and now they're able to compete or something because you made that donation.
And that's the story that you tell when you buy your advertising. Think about, so as I go through my, you know, montage, not my montage, but my timeline, you know, getting into the on-air, being the host, then the producer, then the writer for the commercials. Now I'm working with you to say, okay, Walter, here's what you do at your credit union. Tell the story of the child that helped. Tell the story of the Olympian, the Special Olympics child. What happened with that $1,500 proudly presented by Lasco's Credit Union? Mm-hmm. That's the story that you tell, and the content that you come up with that ultimately you use for your advertising. That's the best form of advertising if you can tell a good story. So I moved from writing and producing and being a production director, an on-air personality, into the direct sales because I really had to get to the front. I was always trying to get to the front of the line to meet you and understand what you need. Mm-hmm. I'm the doctor. You've got to tell me where it hurts. And then from there, we'll apply whatever solution we need. And that was really an eye-opener to see, okay, I've done all the radio shows. I've hosted. I still do. I can write and produce. I can visualize what it is. I can tell your story. And now I start to understand the budget part of it and understand you're going to need to apply this amount of money this many times on this many mediums to have an effective message. And tell a good story. Don't just, again, go Monday through Friday, we're open 9 to 5 here on Main Street, because absolutely nobody heard that message.
Well, you know, it reminds me, too, when we were working together for CU Senior Safeguard for the credit unions in our that are part of our association. And
that's a great program.
And yes, and you've always talked about the importance there of telling the story, and the focus is on telling the story. And there you have the story of all the seniors that, you know, have been scammed and frauded of thousands and thousands of dollars. And that's what will hit home to a lot of the media people, you know, that are looking to have a conversation about this and having that conversation.
Right.
Which leads me to the angle we played that time with the, remember the cabbie driver from Quincy?
That's a great story.
And what we accomplished there.
Yep.
There was, you know, part of this whole program that we were doing was to try and raise greater awareness about the scams and fraud being committed against seniors.
Right.
So what happened is that we saw in the news in the Boston area, in the Boston Globe, a story about a cab driver in Quincy that picked up an elderly senior, an elderly lady, and she asked him to drive her to Lowe's.
Right.
And he engaged her in conversation as they're driving to Lowe's. And she related to him that she was going to buy some of these gift cards because her grandson had been arrested and she needs to help bail him out. And he goes, lady, I think you're being scammed.
Right.
And he drove her instead to the police department in Quincy. And he saved her thousands and thousands of dollars. So
I don't think she was happy about it, but he did the right thing.
Oh, exactly.
Because she was convinced. Somebody had convinced her that her grandson was actually calls and says, the way to get me out of trouble is to go get $5,000 worth of Lowe's gift cards.
That's right.
Because once that the woman would have read those codes, ISKI codes, for lack of a better term, to this person over the phone, the money's gone. We see the story, and Walter built this whole, that the news media ate that up.
Well, what was so nice about it is, at that time, again, we're trying to raise awareness about elder fraud and the scams that are being committed. We see this happening. We go, you know, we have to move quick on this because one way to do it is to reward this guy for being a good Samaritan.
Right.
So why don't we see if we could get a hold of him? Let's get a hold of the newspapers, the TV, whatever we can. Get a hold of the mayor. Go to the senior center in Quincy.
Yep.
And let's get the credit unions to present him, or actually present a check in his name, in his honor, to the senior center to help create a program to raise greater awareness about financial scams and fraud for the, against the elderly.
Right.
That was a big score too.
People showed
doing
up.
Doing something like that, the media showed up. We got some very good coverage. We made, you know, the credit unions look good for what we were doing, and we actually gave him good recognition for what he did. As a matter of fact, I think I have, and I can even share that too. I'll share it right now with you, the coverage that we got from a local TV station on this particular story.
A Quincy cab driver is being called a hero today for stepping up to stop a scam aimed at an elderly woman. This 87-year-old was about to spend thousands of dollars on gift cards, a victim of a ripoff that's become known as the grandparent scam.
The cabbie's actions now mean more seniors will get information about how to protect themselves. Yellow cab driver Richard Spencer was the guest of honor at Quincy's Senior Center. For doing what a lot of people won't do, he got involved. We first introduced you to Richard last month when he picked up an 87-year-old woman.
She says, okay, I want to go to Walmart.
But when he asked her why.
She says, well, I got to get some gift cards. I got a call from my grandson and from the police that he had a car accident. He rear-ended somebody, and that if I didn't come up with $4,000, he was going to jail.
Warning bells went off.
And I, at that point, said, ma'am, I don't think that's your grandson. I believe you're being scammed.
So he brought the woman to the Quincy Police Department.
Well, I just felt it was necessary to, you know, to squash it as best I could, you know.
So today became Richard Day, but for a larger cause.
Today, this industry that's scamming seniors, they're making more than $40 billion a year off the seniors. That's awful, isn't it?
To commend Richard's actions, Massachusetts credit unions donated $1,000 to the Quincy Senior Center for educational efforts to combat elderly exploitation. And the stakes are high.
Over a series of calls, they kept needing more money.
It happened to Clara, who just happened to be in the audience today. Her loss?
$30,000 it did, so, but then I just had to come to terms with that because it was gone.
$30,000. Massachusetts credit unions, by the way, created a program called Senior Safeguards to fight back against scams that are aimed at the elderly.
Yeah, good for Richard Spencer for taking the time to help her that way. It's just infuriating to think people would do this to the elderly.
It's one of those stories that kind of goes both ways. You see that there are evil people out there that are doing this to elderly people, and then there's people like Richard who are helping people.
Good for him. Yeah.
That was a great piece that we did, and it was effective on so many levels, really, because it was the awareness, it was the recognition of the gentleman, the credit unions were involved, the town was involved, the mayor was involved, the news was involved. We created the story. We thought differently and didn't just say, oh, that's a nice piece we saw on the news or in the newspaper. You take it a step beyond, think differently, and reward the guy. Say thank you. Again, I'm sure the lady was a little upset because she had it in her mind that that was her grandson.
Right. But you
he
know,
took her right to the police station and she was getting scammed.
But you know, the other thing too is that you also have to look for opportunities in your cities around you.
Right.
And in that particular case, seeing this in the newspaper where he did this and saying, hey, that ties in with the story that we're trying to do in terms of awareness.
Right.
How could we act? How could we move quickly? And that was also the idea too, right? Because
mm-hmm.
if we waited like 2-3 months
gone.
Later, oh, you're gone. You missed the boat.
Gone.
So we had to act quickly and take advantage of that opportunity so that the press would do us like a follow-up story while now that we gave the recognition to him.
Yeah, and that's really what this whole Think Differently segment is about. You have to think differently when you're marketing your credit union, when you're advertising your business. You have to think differently in your relationships. You have to think differently when you're applying for a job. You know, you just think differently. Don't do the same old, same old. It's going to get you nowhere. Continuing on with where I landed in the career, getting into the sales end of things really gave me that front row seat with clients to understand what is your story. And if you can't tell me your story, then don't advertise because you don't know what to say. Like, if you're selling mattresses, you're not selling mattresses. You're selling a good night's sleep. How's your sore back? Talk about my sore back, my sore neck, the things that are actually happening to your customers, and that becomes your story. So, you know, fast forward, I continued to do on-air radio shows and podcasts now, and I really love that connection with the audience. And again, I have to think differently every time I open my mouth because if I'm boring you, you're gone. If you think differently, though, and understand who your audience is, you're in such a better place. So about 5 years ago, after all those years of working in radio and working with the media, on-air personality, creative writers, sales, all of it, I started my own ad agency, a boutique ad agency that really now I work with the clients. You know, when I sit down with you, we strategize. Who are we talking to? What is the story that we're going to tell, and where do we put that story? You know, this day and age, it's not radio, TV, and newspapers anymore. That is part of the equation, no question. Mm-hmm. But you and I have talked about this. Start tipping into the XR, the AR, the augmented reality, mm-hmm. virtual reality, the way digitally you can literally, you know what people are typing into Google. You know, it's a little scary on some levels, but we know where people literally are on their phones. Everybody's carrying their phones around. How do you use that technology, think differently, find out what your audience is doing, and target those people with your credit union message? It's not easy to do. It's definitely, you know, it's a constant challenge. And if you stop, you think differently. If you just put a press release out there, nobody cares. Even if you donated $1 million today, a lot of other people do that.
See, and the way I look at it too, so you do that. That's like wasting your time. Mm-hmm. I mean, when you think about it, I'm doing a press release. Why? So that I could get attention for my credit union, right. So I could get its name out there, so I could get publicity, mm-hmm. you know, and people become aware of it. If no one's going to pick it up, if the newspapers aren't going to go for it, or television or radio, or it's like putting something on social media.
Right.
If you're not going to get any likes or any hits,
right.
why do you do it?
Right.
It's like you're working foolishly.
Right.
The whole idea is that you're getting hits, you're getting likes, it's going viral. My God, if you could go viral, that's exactly
what
you
want. Social media is a perfect example of having to think differently, because you can't just post a picture. You can't just put a link to something and say, there it is. Nobody cares. If you tell a good story, though, if your business, if your credit union is connected to, again, I go back to the cause marketing. If you're connected to that cause marketing, there are stories right there. I'm working with a credit union right now, and a lot of what they do is support the military. Tell the military stories. They deal with mm-hmm. wounded veterans. Tell the stories of how every dollar you raise is doing something positive for those wounded veterans, you know? And so, you know, here we are. Over all the years, I've seen so many different things of how people would traditionally advertise. And then we constantly, from day one, I don't care if it's 1990 or 2021, you have to think differently. Every single day, you have to think differently. And if that's the only thing you take away from this video, is that you'll stop and say, is a press release the way to go? Or, am I going to do advertising on the radio? Do I want to advertise with Facebook? How do I do it differently? Look, I believe in radio. Say something creative and different that gets my attention.
You know, we're talking about thinking differently. Mm-hmm. We're talking about content and all, you know, we're just talking about social media, newspapers, radio. Let's also remember, Isaiah, we're living in a time today where you have augmented reality.
Yes.
You have virtual reality. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's exploding with the different types of multimedia experiences.
Right.
I mean, where should credit unions be with that? I mean, that's something that,
you know, I
don't want to see anyone miss the train.
You don't want to miss that train. I work with a close friend of mine who's been in the, it's called XR, basically. It's augmented reality and virtual reality. A lot of people have seen virtual reality with the big headsets. Oculus, Facebook has that. And mm-hmm. it's been extremely popular in the gaming space. You know, augmented reality is more of a marketing experience used with your phone. And credit unions need to realize that if you think differently, how do we use this augmented reality and virtual reality to promote our business? Okay, well, you have to think differently. Partner up with maybe some of your vendors. Do some cross promotion. But give me the end user. Give me that experience on my phone, in my house. You want to reach mm-hmm. these people. Don't send me a letter in the mail anymore. Don't send me a postcard.
Exactly.
Or if you do send me a postcard, have an augmented reality, and this is probably bending a few people's minds right now, but have an experience, an augmented reality experience from that postcard on your phone. A good example of that is look up 19 Crimes. 19 Crimes is a wine company, and on the label of all their bottles is an augmented reality experience where you download an app, you put it over the label, and the label comes to life. 19 Crimes, look that up. And I'll tell you, credit unions want to be doing these things before the competitors do it, right? They need to.
Think that we is impossible for mind or body to withstand the continual strain that is upon them. One or the other must give way.
Some may call me traitor, others hero, but I call myself Michael Harrington, Fenian brother, and part of the Fremantle Six.
I was banished to Australia for crimes against the crown. They believed my story was over, but it was merely the beginning.
They called me the informer. Well, forgive me for caring more about myself than the cause.
For the sake of my children, I begged for mercy. But the judge showed me none. I was sentenced to 7 years, transported for stealing bacon, banished from my home.
Up against the wall.
That's a great example of augmented reality. And everyone watching this, all the credit unions, these things can be done. So it's about thinking differently. Again, you may be doing traditional advertising. That's fine. Work it into your ecosystem of a little bit of everything, because people are watching things through an augmented reality lens. People are listening to a radio station or a podcast. People do see billboards, absolutely. People still read the newspaper. You just have to know your audience and tell your story to that audience every single time. So think differently. As we wrap things up here, do you have any final thoughts on think differently or any other examples of things you've done?
I do. Two things. One is I want to call attention, and we've all heard about the purple cow. You want to be the purple cow.
Right.
You want to stand out from the crowd. You want to be recognized. And I think that's something to always keep in your mind. So how do you be the purple cow? You have to think differently.
Right.
And finally, on my end, let me close with another little clip, how thinking differently helped Operation Best Wishes, helped credit unions get media exposure on KYW television in Philadelphia, one of the top markets in the country.
Right.
And we didn't pay a penny for this, but here's what it looked like.
Daddy. I see Daddy.
Good job.
It's Say Hello and a whole lot more on the eve of the fourth anniversary of the war in Iraq. Local families send a message to loved ones.
Next week, there will be a somber anniversary, the fourth anniversary of the war in Iraq.
This weekend, local military families are taking advantage of a special electronic link to their loved ones serving in the war zone. CBS3's Robin McIntosh reports from Burlington County.
Good job, big girl. You're really showing off for the cameras today, yeah.
A daughter's first steps mean a lot to a parent, but even more so to a parent not only thousands of miles away, but in harm's way. Next Monday is the fourth anniversary of the start of the Iraq War. Deborah Gooley's husband, Paul, is an Air Force sergeant serving in Iraq for the past 2 months. He's never seen his twin daughters, Elena and Angelina, walk or crawl. Separation is the hard part.
At first, I was really scared, thinking that I wouldn't really be able to do it because, you know, you cry a lot, especially with new infants, first time being away.
But now that separation made easier thanks to Operation Best Wishes, a three-year-old program sponsored by Westcorp Federal Credit Unions that deal with the military and now are helping raise morale.
The program allows the military to log in with a special password, and they could watch the webcast as it happens live and respond back by instant text messaging.
Today's webcast comes from a Wrightstown office building and sent anywhere in the world today from Burlington County to Baghdad.
I think it's a great idea. My husband was in the Navy 30 years ago, and the only way of communicating we had was letters.
Behind the camera, a Navy veteran and WestCorp employee who volunteered to help out, knowing firsthand just how important staying in touch can be.
Anything we can do to help them, you know, make life better over there is worth its weight in gold.
Operation Best Wishes will be back up and running on Saturday morning between 9 and noon here at the Andrews Federal Credit Union building, right across the street from the McGuire Air Force Base. It's a free service that's helping win the war on separation. In Wrightstown, Robin McIntosh, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
Nothing better you can send to Iraq than that.
So there you go. Operation Best Wish is definitely a way to think differently, and certainly, as I said earlier, a great opportunity I had in my career to really give respect to the military and support for them, and also to help proclaim and tell a good credit union story for
That's
the
great.
Support that we gave. Isaiah, closing comment?
You know, I think back to when you said it was a blessing for you to work with the military. I've got a number of clients that I work with. I work with credit unions. I work with a lot of veterans, too. And I'm blessed that the things that I've done, the work that you and I started to do was to help bring awareness to elder financial abuse. That is a real situation. That, years ago, was a $40 billion industry, and you shared with me the other day it's up to $150 billion.
Yeah.
In other words, there's $150 billion being reported that is being stolen from our seniors, and that's awful. But we got to work, think differently on how to tell that story to prevent it. Also, the work I do with the VA and the Disabled American Veterans, I'm very proud of that because I didn't serve this country, but I try to do everything I can do for those men and women to tell a better story. You know, we had a really, really, we were blessed with the vaccination rollout, that the VA did it the right way, and I stopped down and said, that's the story you tell. All day long, you tell that story that you got there, you took care of your veterans, their spouses, their caregivers, and then continue to tell the story. The individuals, you know, how did that affect you, your father, your mother, your sister? So really just, I'm just, 30 years, I've just had a really good run, and here comes 30 more. I'm excited for more, but I'm always going to think differently, because if I stop thinking differently, my clients, my business, it will dry up. And that goes for you as well, watching, you know, think differently every day, work with your marketing people, reach out to us at the CCUA, we'll help you. I mean, you just have to think differently, and business will be in a good place.
There you go. Isaiah, thank you so much, and thank you, too, for joining us today in our little presentation about thinking differently. Hopefully, this little conversation and our time together planted a seed with you so that the next time you're faced with, do a news release, that you could think differently and really go for the, you know, go for the long ball, home run, in scoring for your credit union and its visibility. Thanks again.